Hello there, my name is Dominic and today I have the solar powered LED wall light with a PIR and CDS night sensor. I don't know what a night sensor is. What I know is that a light sensor actually exists. So we'll check that out. So what I bought is the 20 LED version, which is this light over here. And the other things that came in the packaging are this screw and wall plug and the manual over here. So this light is supposed to charge during the day using this solar panel. And at night, it will turn automatically on when it detects someone. So this is the passive infrared sensor that you saw over here, PIR sensor. And the CDS night sensor, I think, is incorporated into the solar panel. This means that this gadget will only light up during the night, but only if it detects there's someone around it. To power it on, you just need to press this button over here. But now it detects that there's light, but if I block the light over here, it will automatically turn on. So I'm interested in what's behind over here, so let's open this gadget up. Before we go on, I bought this gadget for around 500 Kenya shillings. This is around $5 and some cents added on top of it. And I bought it at a physical shop, I didn't buy it online. This is the exact same gadget that you can see over here on Jumia Kenya website, and over here it costs around 1000 Kenya shillings. This is around $10 and some cents added on top of it. So you have to pay for this amount as well as pay for the delivery fees. So you might say that I got a very good deal. So from what I can see over here, this gadget should be way much cheaper than I bought it for. This is just a glorified torch with a solar panel attached at the top over here. So inside here we have the battery and the logic board. These are the cables from the solar panel, and these cables are from the board to the lights over here. The main board has everything else, which includes the power button, the passive infrared sensor, and a simple logic board over here that interprets the input from the push button over here, the passive infrared sensor, and the CDS light sensor on the solar panel over here. So again, I was right. The CDS sensor over here, which is the cadmium sulfide sensor, is incorporated in the solar panel because you only have two cables from the solar panel. So I can't see anything printed on the battery over here, but if I check the packaging, I can see that the battery is a 1200 mAh battery at 3.7 volts. The solar panel is 0.55 watts at 17% efficiency. And I believe the light is a 3-watt light over here. So the other thing I noticed about this light is that it's not waterproof. So if you actually install this in a place where it's going to be rained on, then this will actually get damaged. I can see these holes over here, which these are meant to be the drainage holes. But that said, the board and battery are well placed at the top over here. Nothing is placed at the bottom over here. So if these holes over here actually get clogged by dust, the water will actually collect inside here and it will actually get into this hole. This is where the light is connected. And you can see this hole does not have any protection over here. I wish they would have put a dab of hot glue like they did on the solar panel connectors over here, but they didn't do that over here. So this is not a waterproof gadget. So to install this light, you just need to fix it to the wall. You can hang it on a nail, or you can use the provided screw over here. You just need the screw for a wooden surface, and you need the wall plug and the screw for a concrete or masonry surface. To activate it, like I said, you just need to press the button. When it's on, that means that it's on. If you press it again, that light is off. Even if you block the solar panel, it won't come on. This is very important when transporting this light. So if I press it again, it will come on. This means that the light is on. So when the night comes and it senses my body heat, it will automatically turn on. I am now in a very dark hallway and you can see the light is on. It thinks that it's nighttime and it's plenty bright over here. Take a look at what happens when I shine my flashlight over here. The light automatically goes off. So you can see that this light is not only triggered by sunlight but by any other artificial light like the flashlights on my smartphone. So this means that you should be very careful about where you install this gadget, because any lights from car headlights, motorbike headlights, street lights will actually deactivate the light. The other thing I want to test is the infrared sensor. Because I know it works on heat, I want to light a candle and place it near it and see if it will actually trigger this light. So you can see that the light is actually on for around 15 seconds or thereabout. So the light is on with only the body heat from my hand over here. So I think a cat will trip this light. A cat or a dog will actually trip this light. So I'm going to do a candle test, and then in the night time I'm going to do a cat and a dog test to see if a cat or a dog will actually trip this light. So what you just saw is the solar wall light being activated by the heat on this candle over here. So let's see now if the solar light will be deactivated simply by shining the light of this candle on the solar panel. That is a very nice loop over there. So it goes off because of the light of the candle, but if I bring it down, it sees darkness, but then it's activated by the heat of the candle. And that is a very good loop over here. So should I recommend this product is the big question. Well, I'm not recommending this product right now because I don't know how it will behave in the future. I don't know if the sunlight will actually beat this plastic up to the point where it starts cracking. I don't know if that will also happen to the solar panel over here. I actually don't know anything. I don't know how many of these lights will actually fail in time. I don't know how the battery will last in time. So I can't say I'm recommending it right now because I'm not sure of how it will perform. I'll do a follow-up video in the future, and in that video you will see if I recommend this product or not. So this video was for my simple experiments so that you can see. If you want to buy, you can actually buy it. I'm not stopping you from buying it. But what I'm saying is that I'm not recommending it right now because I don't know how it will perform in the future. So why I will be using this light, it will actually be used from around 7 PM to around 10 PM in the night. It should be early as maybe 6:30 PM in some seasons. So if it works well in that period and it actually still works at maybe 5 AM in the morning when someone wakes up very early, then I will recommend this product if it works in the next 6 months. So as we wind up, here are some warnings from the manual. Number one, keep the device away from fire and moisture in order to avoid explosion. Number two, any severe shock to the charger is not recommended, so don't drop this light. And number three, no one except professional technicians should attempt to disassemble the charger in order to avoid damaging the charger. I am a professional technician, that's why you saw me dismantle this thing. That's it guys, I apologize for the very long video about a very simple product over here. That's just how my mind works. Thank you again for watching and goodbye.